Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. Blind. Where am I going? I'm going back to Caravanserai. Which I guess we can go either here or yeah, you can get there from Cliff's Edge, actually. So I'll just go zoop.
Of course.
We gotta go pick up Eretis. I'm dropping her off again, Rin. She doesn't look that useful as a companion, and she is a little girl. I really only took her with us to learn more about her and to deal with Tolmagur, which we did successfully last episode, and learn the Tidal Affinity skill. It's a win-win all around, and she's not a slave anymore, Rin, so it's a good thing.
Naturally.
It's entertaining how she interacts with the, Ceratus? No, it's a nano. Here he is. All glowing. Yeah, how she interacts with, the other party members is interesting. Sorry? What is she? She wants what already? Yeah. This is yeah, can't be unequipped. So we didn't give her anything, so
what's going on?
Her voice is loud again. I think it's best we part. I feel bad letting her go, actually. What? Why? You said you would help me. Is it something I did? Oh my god, I feel horrible now. Aww. It's more dangerous for you than I thought it would be. The places I need to go, they aren't safe. Over his gold tide, at least. Nowhere is safe. This morning I went to piss behind a bush and it tried to eat me. Don't leave me. You can't leave me. Oh my god, I feel horrible. I have to bring Eretis with us. If I could bring you all, I would. I really, really would. But, you know, it's a game mechanic. I'm sorry. It's better this way. You'll see. I wish I could tell her I'll check up on her, because I am going to check up on her. If I can. Tears roll freely down her cheeks. Please let me stay. I can get better at fighting. I can. Or whatever you need me to do. Just give me a chance and I'll show you. Right. She wipes the back of her hand across her nose. I'll just forget.
What's going on?
How do we get her back to her family? Where's this Baranth? How do I switch to, like, worldview? Well, there is none. I would. I really, really would. I wish I could bring her to, like... Hold up. I don't think this is an option.
Naturally.
I'd bring her to the portal. the portal through time where the kids go. She has somebody. Oh, this... it's in Government Square, damn it. I feel terrible. I do. I didn't anticipate that she was going to be so upset.
Yes.
I want to find another way, but I don't think there is another way. I'd love to bring her to her home. At least find my way there first.
Trust and honesty are our bonds.
I really doubt this is an option, because otherwise we would have seen it through dialogue.
On it.
The House of Empty Time.
Let's go.
What's going on?
Yes.
Where's this lady who works with him? I never did find out what's going on with these kids. What'd she say? I gotta spend my share on a knife. Golzi is selling a dagger with a claw in the end. It's wicked. I've got so much clink in my pockets, it's a wonder my trousers aren't falling down. Well, we can't examine anything around here. Looks like at some point we can get over here.
I see no evidence for your gods, child. But if they make it easier for you to navigate this world...
Your sisters. Could you always see them?
No. It was the attractor that opened my mind.
Whatever makes it easier for you to navigate this world.
I don't know what to do. Where's this lady? She's gone now?
On my way.
Is it her? No, that's a dignitary. Sangolin. She's simply not here anymore. I guess she left when she fulfilled her function to bring that other kid through. I just want to check in with these guys really quick. Ayin, who knows? I have secrets to exchange. We found this out, I think. Someone in the Order of Truth was a spy. I don't remember if it's for the Mimovira or not. I don't really need to know anything, do we? We found out who the spy was. There can't be more than one spy, right? I mean, they can, but... she almost remembers what her name is. I'll tell you a secret about my past. Okay, I don't have any. Oh, I promise not to tell about the boy. Oh, hey, alright. I'm tempted, should I? Lord Vinken has your Valky blood on his mother's side. That explains a great deal, she says, swiping two fingers the length of her arm. Now for your interesting secret. She traces the corner of her lips thoughtfully. Ah, yes. The construct known as Master Artisan has been able to repair its eyes for years. It pretends to be blind. Huh. Alright. That was random. I gotta let her go. It's just I'm putting it off, I know. There's a glaive, there's another person here. Isn't there? There's another guy over here. You look oddly familiar. I'm not well, you see, and my doctor here is helping me not be unwell. Well, I thought you were here to discuss my wares, my line of specialty products. Oh, Irathar Bryn is the one. Infiltration, sabotage, assassinations, and theft. His eyes flicker to your tattoo for an instant. There's something in that satisfaction behind that smile that catches your notice. He isn't just happy at the prospect of a solid payday. It's the smile of a man who believes that everything is going according to plan. We gotta let her go, I'm sorry. Thought I might be able to find someone who can help you, but...
Yes?
I cannot.
What's going on?
Her eyes well up almost immediately, but she sets her chin and says, "So this is forgetting it, then?" I'm not arguing about this anymore. Just leave. I hate this. She looks like she's about to say something, then she shuts her mouth in a tight grimace. A tear rolls down her cheek, but she slaps it away. Oh, God! Don't do this to me! She turns and runs, a trail of wet spots on the ground behind her. You can hear her choking back sobs as she goes, then she turns and disappears. I feel terrible.
Coming.
Good God. Well, we need to pick up Aratus again. And I want to see if she's back at her home, which is not really a home, but
coming
dear. Cliff's Edge. How about this sylph? Now that I talk to these guys, they're still there. I feel really bad. My God, they made her cry, and you know, they made the voice actor cry, do her cry and everything. God damn it. That's the hardest companion I've had to let go. She's not there.
Coming.
I'm so sorry, my god. She's gone forever. I wonder if I'll run again across her again. I hope I do. I want to bring her back to her home.
Why not?
But it's true. I can't have her on, you know, fighting with me and stuff. Oh, really? Huh. Aretas is puffing out one cheek, then the other, with fierce brow furrowed concentration. The glow about him pulses slowly, like a second heartbeat. Is that what he's doing? He's puffing out cheeks? He's bored? He notices you, brightens, and exhales in a rush. I was about to jump off the cliff and swim to the bottom of that sea. I figured I could trap air in different parts of my mouth before it faded away. Squish it together, you know? He thinks, no, stop talking. Jump now. I wonder if someone's in his brain, like, or in his mind, like loss of self. Assuming you survived the fall, I'm pretty sure you drowned. Really? He says, casting a doubtful look towards the cliff. All I'd have to do is avoid all those rocks and fall fast enough that the water doesn't hurt when I hit it. He chews his lip. And if I run out of air, I'll just swim up faster. Simple. He wiggles his finger at you. I think you've been worrying too much while I've been resting. Let's have some more adventures. What do you say? Sure, let's go. Alright, he's back.
How may I guide
you? Guide me by giving your extra fettle to him. What's the other thing? Imprisoned pulsar? Hmm. Alright, let's give him the pulsar. I feel so bad, guys. Crap. Okay, now we need to go back to the underbelly. It's horrible how she's not going where we can't just get her back. Or she's gone somewhere else.
Something, you know, to do.
Gotta give a lot of credit to the game. She remembered the last time we, you know, told her to leave.
Why not?
And reacted as, yeah, it's the second time. I was expecting the whole dialogue to happen all over again. So, that's pretty freaking awesome. Details like that, that's what I love.
Cue action!
Mm-hmm. Now, we've gone through a lot to, get this.
I am the very soul of action!
To get this skill. So this better work. Chikakt. Title Surge. Unearth the buried knowledge of the Staika language in your mind. Whoa. You turn the tides on yourself, burning away the accumulated detritus of the amnesia settled in your mind. Light flares within your vision, mandalas dancing before your eyes, and a host of images flickers through your memory. You see yourself interacting with a Staikus, exchanging hand signals, a small box between you translating your words and thoughts, forcing your muscles to react. With a rush, information pours into your mind. The smell of granite fills your nose. Knowledge. Loot tide raised a moderate amount. And we took 2 damage, 2 hit points. As you return to normal consciousness, Chikak leans forward.
Chikak, smell granite. Knowledge.
It rumbles. Its spiracles vent a minuscule trace of gas. The Staikus looks at you, and its body posture and slight movements indicate a question.
Does human speak Staikus?
Your muscles remember, and you twitch the proper response. Chikak huffs the scent of lightning.
Never speak Chikak to human so. Heard memory from Elder, not believe. Human almost sentient? Imagine! Grub think like Stykus! Speak smart! Better now!
Although I think if it clapped its hands together it wouldn't sound like my hands, but close enough. I wonder if it has other... Now that we can speak better, ask us some of these questions again. Can you tell me about this place again?
Good tunnel rock. Many hidden paths. Place to store eggs. Store electricity when we dig. Good for eating.
Can we talk about Pelii again?
Fishhead person. Different grub. Shine strangely in Stykus' eyes. Smell bad in mind. Much like other humans.
Its hand tears a chunk from the wall. Not saying either of these. Can you tell me more about the Stykus? It considers the question briefly, and then emits a puff of pheromones that smells of soft rock, crumbling under determined hands. It reminds you of resigned acceptance.
Speak. Chakek will answer.
I found a dead Stykus near here. Can you tell me anything about that?
Nell tunnel. Broodmate weakened. Could not feed self. Could not feed eggs. Takes tunnel to collapse on self. Not want burden Stykus family.
The great head on the creature shakes ponderously.
Barely strong enough to collapse tunnel. Failed in life. Too weak, perhaps.
How did you come to be under Sega's cliffs? It shrugs, its massive exoskeletal plates grinding.
No ancient ever to tell. 4 generations only in caves. We live instinct. Only guess at legacy. Memories stolen.
It pats the wall nearby.
Stykus hatch from egg, yes? Yes. Traitors come from evil bloom. Other worlds. Think human stole eggs. Human brought eggs to world. Humans hatch eggs. Larval Stykus. A mystery to buyer. Released here.
Chakak exhales from its spiracles.
Must guess at function. Must guess at society. Maybe advanced once. Maybe great civilization. Now? Now only dig. Dig for clues. Do not remember. Eggs of forebear stolen to here. Never saw home world. Never saw natural skies. Only know this world. This world not ours.
It keens a tiny song, and the scent of failure and loss hangs heavy around it. Why are you digging here?
This arm.
Chakak raises its great arm.
Dig. Draw energy from rock, from friction. Eat electric charge. Store electric charge.
It points to the spiky growths on its plating.
Here, rock good. Hard. Much electric. Best found. Other places, not good.
Same. Why are you digging under populated areas? The Stykus stares blankly at you, its eyes shimmering. It seems to be trying to put its thoughts into a statement you can understand.
The Stykus must survive. Must live where food is, yes?
It doesn't wait for an affirmation.
Human watch every step? Avoid stepping on insects? No impact on other life? Sacrifice of others is natural order.
It taps you in the chest.
Smart for a human.
It points toward the rest of the underbelly.
Not smart. Why concern? Not...
It gropes for the word.
Not sentient.
You claim that the people in the city aren't sentient. That's not true. The Stykus shifts its weight back and forth.
Simple humans. Fight. Eat. Kill. Try steal eggs. Not harmony. Sentient?
It trills out a scoff. Your digging is causing problems for the people above.
Not concerned to Stykus.
Okay. So that's more about the Stika. Can you tell me about this place? I have come again to ask you to stop digging underneath the city.
Why? Where we go? Give reason to stop.
The humans above are suffering. Red Tide?
When humans dig, they care for us? No. Why we care for them?
You can move deeper beneath the city.
Have been. Rock not good. Soft. Not efficient. Electric not strong.
It leans back.
What else?
Do you want your people to have a future? Yeah, I'm not sure about this power sources. Like, who's going to provide that, and are they going to be willing? So, try persuasion. Do you want your people to have a future? Do you want war with the humans above? They will collapse your tunnels. They will destroy you. I'm going all the way up. I can only go to 65%. This is untrained, mind you. Now, I think... I think I could switch to someone else? I'm not sure. No, I guess not. No! It considers your words for a short time and then looms tall.
No, this home can stop humans if need. Maybe humans move instead. They build on food. They surprised it eaten? We stay.
This is the only way.
Say before no, where we go.
I can promise a regular trip. You know what? Hold up. Let me check with Pelii if possible. Not really. Well, I wish I had an option to talk about or tell them what we found out, why they dig. This is their food and stuff. This is just gonna piss it off and... Chikak, and he can't trust her. Yeah, I'm not sure why I quit out like that. I can promise a regular tribute of power sources for your people from the city. The Stikus leans forward, interested, and a scent of sparks rises.
Why they not offer before? This good. What else?
Hold up. We'll see if this helps. Plus one training level in that skill. Now, I don't think it reflects. No. I think it only... Unless it doesn't show up here, but just while I use it. I really want to, help this come
about.
You're
wearing just a smile? And she let you pass?
Uh-huh.
Of course. It paid my toll, as it were. Many times over.
But where were you keeping her money? In your mouth?
So to speak. So to speak.
Heals 10 points of intellect. We have 5 uses. Not on yourself. God damn it. I just wasted charge right there. Ah. Wait, that's her. Wait, who has that? It has 5 uses. I'm pretty sure Calistige has it. Or had it. Ornament? I used... I didn't use what I think I used. Oh, that's horrible. I wasted that. So, what is this? Energized. It said I had 5 uses. Still. Oh, let me give his thing back. It's good that you actually have a, you know, an item. So what happened to that? I don't know. I'm just gonna go, I'm gonna reload this freaking thing. Okay, now, I don't feel bad reloading because what I thought was happening wasn't really what I was happening. Like, I messed up as far as a gameplay perspective. Plus, this is messed up. Fresh vapors, I'm pretty sure I have never used. We have 5 uses. I used it once, and it was gone. So 10 points of intellect. So I'm gonna go through all the options again. I'm just gonna put this on from the very start. I don't think it really helps. I might have to activate it. Choose one expiration. Now this is an artifact, so this should not disappear. Oh look, a rock just fell and then vanished into nothing. I think I have to choose something. So she has 7 intellect right now. Okay, so I'm gonna go through all these options. All this. this. So I always chose the second option just to get more information. Okay, so that's it for that little submenu. I tried this. I tried that. Because I don't know how long that lasts for, so I just want to get rid of all the other things, and then let's see, I might have to activate this. So this is me. Okay. You have- ooh, look! She's holding it like that. That's cool. Persuasion.
That's the stuff.
So I'm gonna try persuasion here. We get 80 now. It worked. And without the power source. Cool. So I turn it around. I know I did change some things, but initially... Look at that around her head. That's awesome. I wonder how long that lasts for. So I'm assuming we can use it once per rest, something like that. So it considers your words for a time, and the scents that surround it vary from the frightening to the mundane. At last, a smell of synth and strong glass waft past your nose, and Chikex says,
"Human good reason. Yes. Stika comply."
Awesome. I like the Stika comply. So yeah, I kind of turned it around. Originally, I wanted to just go back and, you know, do everything over again, but not use that item. Maybe use one or two of the other, the consumable items that we have in our general inventory to increase intellect that way. By three, I guess I would have used two of them, maybe. So anyway, this is even better. Updated. It scratches the wall and forms a pattern there.
Stika, move deeper. Burrow to lesser rock. Star for human sake. Not fight with humans is better.
I'm glad to see it my way. The giant Stikas huffs unhappily.
Must send other grub away. Pelei, fishhead grub. Tell her we make deal and make her go away.
Sorry, that's like irritating my throat. But we're done talking to him. Well, Pelei, and now I need help from you, I hope. I hope you have news for me. I have news about the Stika. Good news, I trust? I've handled the negotiations with the Stika. She lifts one foot to begin pacing. To start considering her options, and she stops. She slowly turns toward you, each eye rotating separately. That must look freaky. She lowers her foot and turns to face you squarely and bites off each word. What did you do? I convinced Chikek that digging deeper would be a benefit to both the Stika and the humans. There's no need to steal their eggs. Yay! You left their eggs with them? How will we enforce their exile without that leverage? She smooths her crest and blinks her eyes slowly. Fine. We can work with this for now. We have time to engineer another solution. Hey, lady, this is the solution. They're gonna go dig deeper in a safer place. So then you can leave them the hell alone. They'll leave us the hell alone. And just, you know, go about your next order of business. She stops, a thought striking her. Did you promise them anything else? Yeah, power cells. Nope. Nope. Good. Then our work here is complete, and I can return to Council Tower. She hands you a pouch. The city of Sega's Cliffs owes you its gratitude. We got 150 shins. We're getting rich over here. And we gained an Ebon Eyes. I will credit you in my report to the council. Get back here. I need help from you.